They will not hire me because I was that broke that I didn't even have a phone, not even like a flip phone. Hello Tissues, welcome to my second video blog. My name is Denalicious. But before we start with the topic, do not forget to subscribe. I am trying my best to upload videos very, very frequently. Yesterday, honestly guys, I'm sorry, I tried to record a video but I couldn't because my computer was giving me lots of hassles and then my camera was also run out of battery. So things didn't work out yesterday to record this video. Now today, I'm ready for recording this video for you guys. But I have to go, so that's why I'm here on my working clothes. Today's topic is gonna be how I start working in construction. Back in 2009, when I finished university, I graduated from industrial designing. And to be honest, if you ask me, what would you rather do if I was in that time of my life where I can decide between going to college or, you know, like start working or getting into trades, if it was my choice, I would just choose the trades right away or choose getting experience and start working instead of university. Why? I think it was just a waste of time, honestly. And money as well, because going to college is very, very expensive. So if you guys are in between that, I would rather go and travel the world, learn different languages, right, without money, or get experience doing something else. But going to college is just a waste of time. Right now with all the technology, with YouTube, you really can't know many things by just going into the internet. And there are also free apps where you can download the courses, like for Harvard University and many other universities, that you can actually get the courses for free. And if you want to get a certificate, you just pay like $100 and they give you a certificate. If I had the chance back in the day, I would have chosen that option. But going back on how I started in construction, it was like in 2009 when I finished university. My dream was always to come to Canada. I came to Canada. That's another big story. Now, Saskatchewan, which is one of the provinces in Canada, they had this program that if you get a certain amount of experience in one of the trades, you can get your permanent residence. I thought I could actually get a job in my career, which is industrial designing, that has to do lots of graphic designing, but in Saskatchewan, it's more like production industry. There's nothing to do, nothing with media or technologies, nothing like that. So for me, it was very, very hard to find a job on my career. I couldn't find anything, just one job, and then I got laid off. And it was very, very hard for me to find a job in industrial designing /graphic design. It was a point, not even working on a Tim Hortons, a McDonald's, and a Starbucks, they will not hire me because I was that broke that I didn't even have a phone, not even like a flip phone, nothing. So the only thing that I filled up, it was just my email address. That's all I could afford. Like, that's all because it's for free. So obviously nobody called me. I was to a point that I was just be broke. In 2009, that's the first time that I came to Canada. But it was not until 2013 that I found this program. It was like a job offer. They train you to get into the trades. In exchange, I think they pay you like $15 an hour. They teach you how to start on the trades, they teach you how to read the measuring tape, a little bit of the use the skill sets and everything, which by the way, I never use any of this equipment because I am an industrial designer. I was more into my computer, you know, doing 3D, 2D modeling and graphic designing. So I was more on my computer all the time, and then going to the computer out to carrying forms and cutting lumber and everything, it was such a big difference. And I said, well, that would be a very good, like at least to get something, right? Because I was to a point that I was going to be homeless again. Which by the way, if you wanna know how I ended up almost to be homeless in Vancouver, you can comment below and say, hey, what happened in there? How come you were almost homeless in Vancouver? So just comment below if you wanna listen to that story as well. So going back to my topic, it was almost that point that I was really like super, super in necessity to get a job. So I found this and I said, well, I'm just gonna go and see how it goes. You go there, they explain you a little bit about the program, and then they make you an interview because it's not for everybody. You have to go to an interview and then they select certain people that they can match into the program. I got selected, and then you go for the program for 6 weeks and then you do a week in a job site, and if that company likes you, they will hire you. So that was the idea. So that's what I did pretty much. I started a course, and honestly for me it was just in the meantime because I was trying to look for a different job about my career. It was just to
get me passed by. I did the course and then I did 1 week on the job site. And honestly, that first week, it was super, super hard because obviously, like, I was not built, like, my arms or nothing was built to pick up heavy stuff. And at the beginning, I was suffering. And I remember the first week, I was crying every day after work and I was like, I can't do this. I can't do this. This is, like, too much. I need to find another job. But after a month, I will say, I started to get better. I started to get a little bit more fit. I started to get more muscle gain. And that helped me actually lots on the job site. And then I started to relate that with my career. I love businesses and I always wanted to invest in real estate. So I was thinking, well, actually this career is not that bad because if I follow this career, how can I build a house, for example, then I can start investing in real estate. So everything was matching up. I think construction is not a bad idea to know a little bit of, and it's good money and keeps you fit, and it has to do also with real estate that I really like. But that's how I started. The first month was like the hardest. After the first month that I started building everything on my body, it was easier and it was easier and easier and easier until that's how I end up in construction. I finished just my carpentry in March 2019, so not too long ago. I finished my school and I'm just waiting for my results. You have to wait for 6 weeks or I don't know. I'm still waiting for my results. I hope they'll come for any time. But right now in the company that I am, I'm working for PCL and it's a worldwide company. It's a big, big company. But what I'm doing lots right now is just like this huge walls with concrete and massive amount of concrete. My other company that I was working with in Saskatchewan, we were doing a little bit of everything, you know, like Starbucks, and we were renovating Walmart. So that was one of the biggest projects, and a little bit of, you know, concrete foundations and all that. Also, I built my house with my ex-boyfriend back then. We demoed the house that their parents was living in, and then we built a duplex, so his parents live in one side and we were living on the other side. And that was like really, really good for me because I learned so much. It gets me so much confidence about like construction and work, and actually that helped me. And I have to say thank you to my ex-boyfriend and thank you to his dad, because they really taught me a lot. And my ex-boyfriend, he was a superintendent too, his dad was a superintendent too, so I learned, let's say, from the best people that you can actually learn from construction. So I learned lots from them. Thank you very much, Thomas and Jeff. Thank you so much. And then after that, I started investing in real estate. So I started buying houses and I wanted to start, I don't know, just to have a little bit of real estate investments. And that's how I started in construction. The negative part of working in construction is when you have to work outside, for example, on the weather. It doesn't matter if it's raining, snowing, if it's minus 30, minus 40. So I was in Saskatchewan and in there you're really working at minus 40 temperatures, and that's what happened to me like last, just here in December, like working outside, and it was extremely cold. I got pneumonia just because of working outside and never taking care of myself and working like 10 hours a day, 12 hours a day. It was very hard. If you're a girl and you're thinking to work in the trades, I will suggest you to just try it. For this, it's not for any kind of women, I think. Like, I've seen other girls on job sites, but sometimes they're like, very like, oh, I don't wanna touch that. You had to be exposed to tools and to heights. Of course, you had the right to refuse work that you feel it's unsafe to yourself, but usually you don't want to refuse all the time because it doesn't look good and you're gonna get fired right away. So if you're a girl and you're trying to get into the trades, I think it's for a certain kind of girls. Now, you can also be a finisher and that doesn't require too much heavy lifting. Well, it does sometimes. It's more like, you know, detail oriented. What I do is more like rough carpentry, which has to do with concrete, a little bit of framing, and pretty much concrete, which I, please kill me right now. The bad thing of being a woman in the trades is that sometimes they look at you and yes, you're a woman, so I'm short, I'm tiny, I'm 5'2", which I'm very, very tiny compared to Canadians that are like twice my size. So everything gets me to here. Actually, I got my first verbal warning my first week at work, because when I'm working, I really don't care if it's safe or not safe. I just care about to get it done. I just jump anywhere. I could be in a 2x4 and on the side of the ladder and try to climb on the walls and try to do my job. But in this company, it's everything like super, 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 super safety. So I cannot even be one side on the ladder and on the other side on a 2x4. I can't do that, which is a 2x4 is a piece of wood. I can't do that in here. You're on the lift and I'm tiny, so the lift gets me to here, where like regularly to guys, it gets them to here. So it's easier to work. For me, I have to work like this. Also, everything is heavier because you're shorter. So the shorter side, you carry more the heavy load. Honestly, being tiny on a job site is not that fun. Also, like, look, like I really can't take care of myself. As you can tell, lately I've been having that dispute that I really want to start taking care of myself because I want to, I want to start looking pretty, and I haven't had the chance to really take care of myself. By the way, I'm going to start doing that pretty soon. Actually, tomorrow I have my first IPL appointment. I'm just going to do a video about that, how it goes. But that's the bad thing, right? You're going to have fancy nails. So girls, you can not have fancy nails. I'm just going to say goodbye to you guys. I have to go. I hope this video helped you to understand a little bit of construction of what I do. If you have any questions, comment below, and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and see you in the next video. I hope this helped you a little bit, and remember, always follow your dreams. Okay, love you guys, see you next time. Bye bye.